I'm Matthias from Witcher 3 REDkit team, and in this short tutorial, I just wanted to show you how to add lip sync animation and audio to your scene files, as it was quite often requested by you guys. So we just wanted to add a little bit extra to actually let you guys know how to do that. So let's jump straight in. So I have an already existing project consisting with one custom scene that I have been created. And in here, you can see the preview, and we have already have some minimal amount of screenplay. And as you can see in the sections, you can select them. And in the properties menu on the right, you can see under the C story scene line section that there are two custom properties that you can use. Both of them start with overridden. So you have an overridden lip sync file path where you can override the lip sync of the scenes, and also one for the audio file, so that you can override the actual audio. The reason for that you can use both of these properties, not just with the newly created scenes, but you can also override lip sync and audio for scenes that are already existing in the game, like vanilla scenes. So in both cases, you can use these fields to actually add audio and lip sync from your custom repository or whatever. And the second half of the story is that actually you need to have Blender set up, and also you will need to install a Blender plugin for that supports handling all sorts of RE animation files and formats that the engine, Red Engine, uses. So just the quick overview how you can actually install that. So if you hop over on the Edit Preferences menu, in the Preferences, in the Add-ons section, you can actually see all of your add-ons that are currently installed. But to install a new one, you will need to go to this Install button over here. And doing so, you will actually see that on a new like open file dialog will show up. And in here, you need to find your REDkit installation path. For now, I'm using Steam currently. So for me, it's Steam Apps Common Witcher 3 Editor. And inside the bin folder, let's just jump a little bit back. So inside bin folder, tools, Blender plugin, you will see that all of the Blender plugin and like Blender related stuff will be located in here, the folder called Blender plugin. And to actually install the plugin for Blender, you need to use this zip file called Blender RE Animations plugin. Click on Install Add-on. And the next step, you just need to refresh your list and find the plugin called, yeah, here it is, Import Export Red Engine Animations Import Export. So make sure that this one is checked. You may need to restart your Blender once you initiated this, but the point is that once this is initiated, then you can pretty much use more formats from the Import and Export menu. And also you will be able to use our customly made Blender projects. One of them is mainly involving with editing, showing, and also creating custom lip sync animations for your audio. I already did that, so I already opened one of the projects. You can find these projects in the same location. So if you click on open, you will see that in the same format, so bin, tools, Blender plugin, you will see that there's a folder called Blender project files. And in here, you can also see that there's two projects, one's for simulating Geralt's body and also Geralt's head. Right now, we need the Geralt head project because we will mainly using lip sync animations. So open that one up and you will see the following screen. In here, you will see that at the right bottom corner, there are different phonemes. Each are basically responsible for moving different parts of the facial structure of your model. And in here, you can just open up all the existing lipsync animation files that you can find on various parts of your depot. And the other way that you can actually, preview your own stuff, your custom made animation, is that firstly, you need to have an audio file. And for that, I already had one that's basically my voice saying, hey there or hello there, because that's the screenplay saying, but you can get any kind of audio file. What you need to look out for is that the format that it accepts is WAV files. And this WAV file needs to be in a 60 kilohertz sample rate. And for best results, we recommend you to actually use a mono files instead of stereo formatted files. So for this reason, I just created a 60 kilohertz sample rate mono WAV file. And to actually import audio inside of here in this project and actually simulate lip sync to it, you need to head over to this scene collection file called H01MG Geralt Lot 0. And in here, by right-clicking to it, you will see that there's a context menu option called import.reanimation. So if you want to have simulate an already existing animation, you can do that. But right now, we want to generate one, generate a mimic animation from .wav file. So we need to do that. And for that, I'm just going to navigate to my own project in a bit. So I just opened my project folder, and inside of my project folder, there's already a audio file for my purpose called hell.wav. So it needs to be a WAV file again. And if having that selected, I just click on automated lip sync generate. And once you successfully imported your file, then you should see that some of the phonemes will be populated with different data on the timeline. Now, if you had any kind of problem while importing it, then you might need to check your format of the format of the used WAV file, because it will only allow you to import it if you are using 60 kilohertz and it's mono. So in here, you can actually preview the animation on the left and the right side of these viewports by pressing this play animation button.
Hello there.
You can actually see how the animation will look like. You can also manually tweak these phonemes to your liking and have some experience with it. But once you are happy with the result and you want to export it as an RE animation file so that the render engine can accept it and you can import it into the scene script, you need to head over and use the same context menu right here and press on export.re mimic animation. So as you can see, it will try to name the RE file the same way as the audio was, so hello 2 for this example. And we can, export it to the same place. And from that point, you can head over back to the editor. And to override the audio and lip sync, you just need to get over here and choose your file for the audio. So remember not to mix up. So right now we need to select the audio file because we selected that property first. And be careful not to put your RE file as your audio file, because in that way it will not work. So press hello2.wav, open. It will insert the audio and it will translate it to a WAV file that the editor can translate. And once you close it, you will realize that the section span was changed to the actual span of the audio. So right now it's roughly about 3 seconds because the audio is that long. And the last thing that we need to do is to actually apply the lipsync animation to it the same way, but this time we need to select the RE file for the animation. Click on open, hit on close. And once that's done, you will see that both of the properties are populated and we can preview the scene. And you will see that the lipsync animation is now working with the audio, presumably. So that's pretty much all that I wanted to talk about, how you can add audio and lipsync to your scenes. Hope you enjoyed this and see you guys in the next one. See ya.